Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the trap series right here at BusyWorksBeats.com/trap. You are a part of the golden era. We're in a new era. And I got to thank Lil Yachty because somehow he made it so that you can have hard trap drums and a happy melody. I don't know how he made that happen, but shout out to Lil Yachty for making that happen because he pushed the genre forward. Same thing to Bryson Tiller, who added R&B over trap drums. And now we get to see, we can add musicality to trap. And now we have infinite options. So if somebody ever tried to pin you against the wall saying you're just a trap producer, trap is running the game. And not only just that hard Jeezy trap or like the hard Rick Ross trap, but you have trap drums with, like I said, Lil Yachty, Bryson Tiller, Tory Lanez. I mean, the names go on and on. P&B Rock, on and on and on and on. All the top acts who can sing are now over these trap drums, and you have the advantage because you know how to make hard drums. And we even released a new course called Drum Magic, how to create hard drums, and Curtis King reveals all of his tricks on how to make banging drums. He's even leveled me up as far as my drums because it's all the techniques I overlooked. So Vintage Fire is a new plugin we created, and it always gives me a vibe. This is authentic analog sound for the digital world, and I handcrafted these sounds manually, and I've added them to one specific plugin. We're coming out with an update as well, so you get even more sounds. But this always gives me a vibe. So I'm going to start with this because this is analog stuff, and analog stuff is different than digital because of the vibe factor. So let's start with some chords. Now for these newer genres, you have to think really outside the box when it comes to chords, because now we're getting into the realms of borrowing from gospel, borrowing from neo soul, borrowing from, really deep R&B back in the 90s where they had some crazy chord progressions and crazy melodies atop their piano playing. And we have to take those genres and make them sound modern without sounding 80s and cheesy. So I'll show you how to do that today. So the first step is to have a big chord. Now I'm going to brush through a lot of topics because I can't spend 50 minutes going over scales, scale degrees, modes, chord codes, and all these things. I can't do that all in one video. We have that right at busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. But what I want to start with is a ninth chord. The reason I'm using a ninth chord is because it has five notes in it. And when you have five notes, you have a lot of flexibility. So let's just start with D, F, A, C, E. That will be our ninth chord. And that's called a D minor 9. Here's what it sounds like. Let me turn up analog Vintage Fire. The reason I have the volumes not blasting your ears out in Vintage Fire is because I want you to be able to have a lot of headroom to do whatever you want with the sound, just like I had a lot of headroom when I was designing the sounds. I don't want to force feed you effects that you don't like. So crank up your volume as you please, and that will give you a bigger sound here. Okay, so what I like to do is trick the listener. But before I trick the listener, let's go from, I gotta keep it short because I don't want to go into a long explanation, but we're going from the tonic to the fifth. That's the first key. Okay, and it's always gonna sound pleasing, so I'm gonna copy that over. Whenever you go from the tonic to the fifth, back to the tonic and the fifth, that's a nice place to start if you're doing this modern R&B thing. I found a new artist, Polari. He really masters that. Like that modern chord progression sound, and then his melodies and the trap vibe. It's just a beautiful place that we're in. We're in the golden era of production. I mean, there's no more boxes on your creativity as a trap producer anymore, especially if you learn music theory. But what I'm going to do to make this custom, the way I think about these genres is I think about the top, like a note being the top note. You don't always have to think this way, but right here, the E, I'm going to make that my top note. So every note above it, I'm going to make sure I invert the notes or pull them down an octave. So I'm going to grab that G and B and pull that down. And it creates a unique vibe because when you have notes that are really close to each other, it creates a sense of tension. So to make this chord even fuller, I'm going to copy the bottom note and I'm going to hit Control down to pull it down an octave. That way we have a nice spread out sound with a lot of bass structure so that these notes that I pull down an octave feel like they're fitting in a bigger chord, even though they already did. Now, my favorite thing to do at the end is to use diminished chords. Now, diminished chords, you can take this up to a ninth, a seventh, whatever. The trick is to take your top note and just count three at a time. So delete all your notes. So it's this, one, two, three. One, two, three. And we went over the magic of three in the secret BPMs video. So you need to go watch that about the Pythagoreans and their secrets. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. So we can make an infinitely large chord. One, two, three. Because you can just keep counting three and it will always because it's 3, 6, 9, 12, and 12 is an octave, so you're going to keep repeating the same notes. So basically you can have up to 3, 6, 9 four notes, and they're just repeating themselves. So this is a four note chord but repeating itself. And it sounds good because it can be infinitely complex. And I left the bass note from the other, where we at the fifth here, so that it resolves on the fifth. I mean, not resolves, but it ends on the fifth. Another trick I like to do, so let's say you don't want to use diminished all the time. That's like my secret weapon for turnaround chords or passing chords, whatever you want to call them. Another trick you can use is to use the opposite chord of the chord prior. So this is a minor chord. All I'm going to do here is copy this over. Now technically this is supposed to be A minor, so let's pull this down so we can see. And I'm going to convert this A minor into an A major 9 chord instead. And let's hear what this sounds like. Now I'm going to do the same technique, pull it up an octave, and I'm going to make sure these top two notes don't go above E. Let's hear what it sounds like collapsed like this. So you can see, you can get really unique chords this way, and this is just the tip of the iceberg. We go over so much in Chord Magic right at busyworksbeats.com/chordmagic. There's so much in that course about neo-soul chords, gospel chord techniques, R&B chord techniques, pop, trap, hip-hop, and even rock chords. We go over some techniques. We go over all this basic stuff, but it adds up to this complexity. It adds up to a lot of complexity. It sounds really unique. Now let's switch out the sounds. That's another technique. Kind of like this vibe because it has a metallic sound. It was modeled after the 80s movie Stranger Things. I named it Stranger Dings because it's a bell, and it just reminds me of those fun 80s bells from that kind of movie vibe. So that's our vibe. Now I said these sounds have vibe, and you saw the little small thing I did, added an LFO depth to the panning so that it kind of wobbles left and right in your ear, and it gives it a little more life. Feels like it's popping out almost. And analog sound just has a depth to it. It has a depth that you just can't get with digital software. So I've added that in this plugin in Vintage Fire. It's our new plugin. You can find it right at busyworksbeats.com/vintagefire. Now let me add my little twist to it. I like to add glitch. And glitch is my new go-to glitching tool. I guess it's the only word for it. I'm going to add retrigger. And I like to pull the mix level down to about 60%. I don't like to have it all the way up. And it just adds a little more bounce and rhythm to it. Now let's add some more R&B techniques that I showed you in the videos prior, which is to add that slide note, or whatever you want to call it, glissando, if you want to call it. There we go. Blues note, whatever you want to call it. There's also different, we go over in Chord Magic how to do different chord voicing, but I'm not going to go over everything right in this video. Now, the magic in some of these sounds is in FL Studio. If you go to the wrench tool, turn on the arpeggio, you're going to hear some insane things. Because some of these sounds I was designing while it was in arpeggio mode, and I had to take it off arpeggio mode so that you didn't have arpeggiated sounds all the time. So some of these sounds, these secret presets, sound crazy in arpeggio mode, arpeggiated mode. So let's turn it up 3 octaves and let's switch out the time. Arpeggio, long story short, okay? There's so many anecdotes I can make. It depends on how many notes you have. So here we have 2, 4, 6, 7 notes, actually 8, but it has 7 notes, so it's throwing off the rhythm of the arpeggio. So just keep that in mind. That's why the rhythm kind of restarts halfway through. This is what makes your chords more unique. Playing style, how you structure your piano roll, sound selection, and how you structure your chord voicing. It all adds up. So I'm just showing you how far you can take it. This one sounds crazy for trap. Just sounds that, man, going back in time, seeing how many sounds I've created in this plugin for you, it just shocks me. Because I remember when I was creating beats a while ago, listening to beats, there was always something about a hit song that had that sound that was just different. It could have been the squeal of a chair. It could have been some synth. I don't even know. It could have been some squeal from an EDM track. But it's always a sound in these hit songs that just sounds completely different from everything else. And this preset right here gave me that feeling. Now I want to add drums. How about in the next video, let's add drums to this, because I don't want to make this an 18,000 minute video, but I just wanted to show you my chord techniques, and you can learn so much more at busyworksbeats.com/chordmagic. We've actually updated the course, and there's so much more in the course. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/chordmagic to learn more. I'll leave a link below. It's busyworksbeats.com.